I would like to welcome all the devotees for Bhagavad Gita class. So, we have been discussing about the overview of the chapter number 3, and we have reached till text number 15. Sorry, not 15, actually 16. 16, no, 15, 15. That karma brahmohot bhavam vidhi, you must understand that the prescribed duties for the humanity is born from or arising from or prescribed from Brahma. Brahma means the Vedas. And Vedas, Brahmakshar Sumad Bhavam, the Vedas are coming from the Supreme Lord Himself. Tasmat, therefore, somebody follows the injunctions of Vedas and performs Yajna. Tasmat, therefore, Sarvagatam Brahman, the Supreme Lord who is transcendental to material nature, who is all-pervading, is present in, always present in Nityam Yajna Pratishtam. Just neglect the spelling mistakes. Nityam Yajna Pratishtam is always nicely situated. I saw sound is strange. Reduce the sound of the speaker a little bit. No, just change the direction of the speaker toward this. Hare Krishna. Is it okay? But it's better. It's not the AC. The echo is not there. No, touch mat kijiye. Wahan se thoda sa kam kijiye. Halka sa kam kijiye. Bahut minutely. Hare Krishna. It should not be too less. I mean you can do without it also, but little bit increased has to be. Hare Krishna. I think it's okay now. Take it. Because less people, then is more eco. So what we have discussed up till now, that the Supreme Lord is always situated in the performance of Yajna. And that's why when we perform Yajna, we get purified. So I was reflecting upon it that some of the statements yesterday might feel very strong. That this much money I should good for Krishna Seva or whatever, for Yajna and all that. But we tend to forget that behind all these injunctions, the purpose of human form of life is there. And that purpose of human form of life is to get purified and go back to Godhead, not become a great prisoner in this material world. If that is understood, then everything makes sense. I am not saying to one particular person, but suppose you had a salary of 40,000 rupees and you get a raise, you'll eat more chapatis. But still a person will not, it's not that he will give all the Lakshmi which he has got extra, will give to Krishna. Will he? He will not. Kuch grahan kar raha hai is baat ko. So reflect on our own heart, how much we want to accept the teachings of Bhagavad Gita. Everything belongs to Krishna. It's not that something belongs to us and we are giving to Krishna. Already everything belongs to Him. We don't want to recognize that point. And to the degree we recognize it, to that degree we become happy. We did not bring a single rupee with us when we came to here. This one, this material world, in this life. So then from that you must understand what is the great danger of accumulating money. I'm telling of my own experience with my Lakshmi, which I would not say even earn, but I had purchased some vessels. And when I was about to join, there were 3,000 rupees worth of vessels. So a thought had come in 2007-8. I still remember, oh, what about these vessels which I have purchased with my own money? So it was always remember that earning money is a dangerous proposition. We tend to become attached. Almost always tend to become attached, although we know it can be taken away from me at any point of time. It doesn't belong to me, but the mind doesn't listen, is it not? So anyways, to the degree a person wants to get purified, to that degree he should do Yajna. And if he does not, then let's see what does the Lord say. I think this is the next sloka. Yes. So if a person does not live a life of Yajna, that means actions or life filled with actions offered for Krishna, then evam pravartitam chakram nanu vartayati hayah agayurindaya ramo mogham partha sajivati evam pravartitam chakram. This chakram, this cycle which has been given, what was the cycle? No, birth and death. Not all the cycles are referring to birth and death. ग्रेन्स विल गिव पोषण और नरिशमेंट टू द ह्यूमन बींग्स. ह्यूमन बींग्स परफॉर्म यज्ञ. यज्ञ इज बॉर्न फ्रॉम एक्शंस. एक्शंस सॉरी 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 ग्रेन्स आर कमिंग फ्रॉम क्लाउड्स. फ्रॉम द ग्रेन्स ह्यूमन बींग्स आर नरिश्ड. ह्यूमन बींग्स परफॉर्म यज्ञ. फ्रॉम यज्ञ यज्ञ इज बॉर्न फ्रॉम कर्म. And from karma comes yagya, from yagya comes cloud, and from cloud comes rain. फिर से समझें. The clouds, grains nourish the human beings. Human beings, human beings do activities. From those activities which are offered Krishna or Vishnu, that is yagya is manifested. Because yagya will only be called to be yagya when the activities offered to Krishna. It's not that any activity is yagya and it's in and of itself. It's not that I will speak anything and it's yagya. Only when I speak about Krishna that it is yagya. Theek hai. Then from yagya, cloud will happen and from clouds, grains will happen. Like this cycle. Evam pravartitam chakram. Na anuvartaya. Anuvarti, you understand? Anuvarti means who does not follow. He is not obedient to this cycle. Who does not participate in this cycle. Who does not practice this cycle. Vart, na anuvartaya tiha. Iha means that person, anyone who does not follow in this world, this cycle. Iha means in this world. Aghayu, agha means sin and ayu means life. His life is full of sin. Why like that? Indriya Ramo. He is dedicated to please his senses only, not offer anything for the Lord's pleasure. Mogham Parth Sa Jivati. Mogham means useless. O Partha Sa Jivati Mogham. That person lives uselessly. That means he dies also uselessly. It seems to be quite heavy, is it not? But before we go forward, can we reflect all those, or if you any know anyone of your relatives or anyone who has not been a devotee and who has died of COVID or whatever in any other way, now you realize his life is wasted. See, when we are living in this life, we think that we are wasting our time. Sometimes we may think, doing this, getting up early in the morning, chanting Hare Krishna, especially new people, not your accomplished devotees, you don't think like that, is it not? You are dedicated to the perseverance of absolute truth. But that, what people will think, is it not? Kya kar rahe? Time barbaad kar rahe. But reflect in our own life, whatever bhakti we have done, if we have to die today, still we have such a great, so much in our bank account already, is it not? How much? 16? How many years you have been chanting 16 rounds, Ayush Prabhu? 4 years and 4 crore names. 4 crore names. Mataji, how many years you have been chanting 16 rounds? 5 months. So that means how much? Kitna ho gaya? I don't know. Almost 50 lakh names and one name destroyed, unlimited sinful reactions and so much bhakti is already increased. Just that it does not manifest immediately. Just like your fixed deposit does not give you returns immediately. But you are happy, is it not? It's my fixed deposit. Majburi mein kam aayega. Is it not? Is it not? So, and reflect upon all those people who have not done bhakti. Just like your sister also left the body, is it not? But she did some bhakti, you know, 1 round, 2 round she chanted. She must have taken prasadam. So you have assurance. Definitely she will get a human form of life. Minimum. Minimum. And she will continue with bhakti. Samajh raha hu aap meri baat? If that is there, then you are relieved. From that point of view, we should realize what is the value of our material actions and what is the value of our spiritual actions. It's a very important point. Mogham Parth Sa Jivati. It's a quite heavy look. Uselessly he lives. So if we don't condemn people, we know that they are living useless. So let them be engaged in Krishna's service. Now we have a new trick. One of our devotees' father wants to edit. I said, okay, you can find some, you can do the editing of the files which I'm going to send in for evening class, Hindi editing. So now he has to focus on the commentaries of the acharyas. And it's good that he's finding taste in it. It will go to his eternal credit. Doesn't make sense? This yagya is happening. We are having this Bhagavad Katha yagya. Somebody sponsored prasadam. Somebody can help in editing. Somebody does so many things. Is it not? All the devotees were participating in the class. Everybody is performing a yagya and everybody gets equal benefit. Kuch grahan kar rahe hain. If there was nobody, then I am lesser enthusiastic to give class. I am telling you, one of my friends in Indonesia, I told him, I initiated the process of Bhagavatam classes there in a tutorial form. I said, you please continue. He could not. Now he's struggling. He's a good devotee, but doing something alone is very difficult. I already started much after him. I went there 2 years back. So you just imagine, I went there 2 years back. And I started Bhagavatam in this year. We already reached 1.5.28, 29, 30. And he has still not been able to post 1.5.31 or 30 also. Kuch grahan kar rahe? Because somehow that he is not able to get the sangha in which this discussions can happen regularly. Does it make sense what I am trying to say? That any yagya, are so many people are involved, and all of them, when they come together, it is very easy to perform yagya. Just like you are seeing every day on Zoom, it is so easy to perform chanting Hare Krishna. Otherwise, chanting Hare Krishna seems to be simple but not easy. So to live a life which is not useless, we need people who are useful, who are living such a life. ठीक है, ओके, नाउ, बट इफ अ पर्सन एंड व्हाई ऑल दोज ड्यूटीज हैव टू बी परफॉर्म्ड, बिकॉज टू गेट सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन. बट देर आर सर्टेन पीपल हु आर ऑलरेडी सेल्फ रियलाइज्ड, दे आर ओनली सेटिस्फाइड इन देयर आत्मा. सो फॉर देम देर इज नो ड्यूटी टू बी परफॉर्म, बिकॉज ऑलरेडी दे आर एक्टिंग फॉर कृष्णस प्लेजर ऑल द टाइम. That is a shloka. Yastu atma rati reva syatma atma triptascha manavah atmani eva cha santushtas tasya karyam na vidyate. I think it's very easy to understand. Yastu, tu means but. Yeah, but that person, atma rati reva syat, who simply satisfied in his self. In the sense, he satisfied in his relationship with Krishna. We gave the example of Madhavendpuri path also, if you remember this. Atma triptascha manavah, is fully satisfied in an atma. It means he is fully satisfied with bhakti. He doesn't have to perform any of the actions which are prescribed by Vedas. You remember when we also quoted that a person who is taking pleasure in chanting Hare Krishna, Vedas have nothing to say to him. Kuch nahi kehne ki zarurat hai usko. He is only transcended Vedas. Samajh rahe hain? Atmani eva cha santushtas. Atmani means in the atma. He is simply satisfied in the atma, in the realization and the bliss of atma, in the bliss of serving the Supreme Lord. Tasya karyam na vidyate. For him there is no duty to perform. But we must remember, not all of us are on that platform. So, but there is an example of such person. So we can't blame that person. Oh, Shripad Madhavendpuri, he is not doing this, he is not doing this. He doesn't have to do all those things. He gave the example, oh, three times bathing, oh, three times Sandhya Vandan, very, very good. I pay obeisances to you, but I am sorry, I cannot serve you. Because, why? Because wherever I go, I can simply remember the enemy of Kansa. Who is that? Krishna. And I think it is sufficient for me. Theek hai? It's not that easy for us, so we must perform the duties. For us, the duty means duty prescribed by the spiritual master, Krishna. Through the spiritual master, Krishna is giving us the duties, sadhana bhakti. Why like this? He says, naiva tasya krite na artho na krite niha kaschana na chasya sarva bhuteshu kaschid artha vapasraya. Naiva nahi hi tasya. Such a person who is simply such a satisfied in himself, certainly there is no kritena artha. He does not need to do something to get some goal. His goal is achieved. Na akritena kaschana. And if he does not do certain duty, he does not lose anything. He has already realized his atma, so he does not have to do a duty to do his to realize his atma. And if he does not do some duty, he will not lose the realization of atma. ऐसा देख रहे जैसे कुछ पढ़ाया नहीं है, पढ़ा पढ़ा कर खून प्राण बाहर आ गए, सब पढ़ा चुके इस चीज को. a person who is attending this class for the first time, this is not the way I teach. This is only overview class. So yesterday some devotee was saying, it's too fast, I can't understand. I expect you to not understand. If you have not heard individual shlokas, it's very difficult to understand these shlokas. Theek hai na? And you can understand this, the language is very, very complicated. What does it want to say? Na chascha asya sarva bhuteshu kashchid artha vipashraya. He does not depend on any other living entity for his survival. Kuch unse udhar unka muh dekhne ki jarurat nahi. He does not have to look at their faces. He does not have any expectation from anyone. Kuch nahi samajh mein aa raha hai. Just like Sukadev Goswami, is it not? He was completely nirapeksh. He was not expecting anything from anyone in this material world. Theek hai? See, we will expect that only if we have material desires. If we don't have any desire, material desires, we don't expect anything from anyone. Ye devta kuch de de, this demigod will do this, give this to me, or some mundane some person will give me. Then you may say, oh, arey bhai, toh, who will provide for his material necessities? Who will provide?
Krishna.
Krishna, directly. Prahlad Maharaj. Now is very easy to understand. Yes. So, therefore, kahan se aa gaya isme? A person who is fully realized in his self does not need to depend on others. Therefore, to attain that stage, one should act in a way, in a detached manner. In text number 17 and 18, this exalted self-realized state was explained. But everybody is not at that stage. So how one should act so that he can reach that stage will be explained in this one. Tasmat. Kuch grahan kar rahe hain. Just like we say, we should chant Hare Krishna nicely. Srila Rupa Goswami was experiencing when he chants Krishna, there is so much taste that he won't desire billions and billions of tongues. Therefore, now you understand? Therefore, we must regularly chant Hare Krishna. Can you follow the link? If I want to experience this taste in one after whatever many lives of time, lifetimes, I must do my sadhana bhakti properly. Because devotees who are experiencing love of God are so blissful. Therefore, you must do sadhana regularly. You means three fingers towards me and two towards you. One towards I don't know who. Zoom devotees. Okay. Grahan kar rahe sab baat. The goal is shown and therefore you should practice like this. Theek? बहुत प्रश्न मत कीजिएगा आज प्रश्न करने का संभावना नहीं है आई डोंट हैव मच टाइम टू आंसर क्वेश्चंस टुडे आई अज्यूम दैट यू आर ऑल सेल्फ रियलाइज्ड आई मीन एटलीस्ट यू अंडरस्टैंड टेक्स्ट बट ऑल द टेक्स्ट आई एम जस्ट हेल्पिंग यू टू रिमेंबर थिंग्स ओह सॉरी आई डिडंट एक्सप्लेन दिस तस्माद असक्तः सततम असक्तः मीन्स नॉट अटैच्ड टू द फ्रूट्स ऑफ द एक्शन तस्माद देयरफॉर सततम मीन्स ऑलवेज Always not being attached to the fruit of the action. Fruit of the action, samajh rahe hain? Swarg, going to swarga, or material benefits which may come from those duties. Karyam karma samachara. You must do your actions prescribed for you nicely. Asakto hi acharan karma. If a person acts in a way of detached manner, if it is not attached to the material mundane fruit from the coming from the action, param apnoti purushah. Apnoti means he achieves the supreme abode. Purushah, that person achieves. Then he gives the example of people who have attained such states by performing their prescribed duties along with bhakti. So please chant up with me. कर्मणैव हि संसिद्धिम् आस्तितः जनकादयः लोकसंग्रहम् एवापि संपश्यन् कर्तुमर्हसि कर्मणैव हि संसिद्धिम् आस्तितः जनकादयः जनक इज द फादर ऑफ मदर सीता सो ही एंड अलोंग विद अदर्स हु वर रूलर्स ऑफ किंगडम हु वर किंग्स they performed the prescribed duty of the king. And in the commentary we have heard, it was not only prescribed duty, but they were also hearing and chanting about Krishna. So without bhakti, nothing will work. So they were offering the fruits of their actions to Krishna, or you can say they were working in a detached manner. Several times we have given this example, a cashier in the bank counts so much Lakshmi, crores of Lakshmi probably. I don't know, I'm not a cashier, but he must be doing that much. But does he do in a detached manner? Yes. And if he takes 200 rupees while counting 25,000 rupees, will it be a problem? Yes. Now you understand? If we claim whatever money which is coming to our account as ours, 200 rupees bhi nahi, nothing, not even 2 rupees. Everything will, 1 rupee to nahi, 1 rupee bhi nahi. So Krishna is allowing you to use 50%. You are not giving him to 50%. I don't want to come to these classes anymore. They are too heavy. It's a real joke. It's a really joking thing. One time, somebody asked, I'm not sure who asked Yudhishthira Maharaj. I think it was that Yaksha who asked. I believe it was like that. I don't remember who asked, but it's really funny. So he asked Yudhishthira Maharaj, who is greater? A person who is tapasvi, who is doing austerity, or a person who will give donation? Yudhishthira Maharaj says, no. A person who gives donation is superior to tapasvi, an ascetic. And why like that? Because money is called bahi prana, external life air. Somebody is giving some money, so he's giving his prana to offer to you, actually. It's a fact. But Krishna says that, is it not? Madgata prana? Madgata prana? My devotees are offering their prana to me. What is the difficulty? That's why in my life, I don't focus on earning money. I don't say that you should not focus because somebody should need to give donation also. But in my life, I feel very happy to have knowledge. Because as of now, I suppose any class I give, I don't hold back anything. I think you understand that. I don't hold back. And there is no danger that if you listen to Bhagavad, you will be a terrorist. Is it not? If somebody will hear Bhagavad, he can't do anything wrong, is it not? Rather, jo wrong kar raha hai, wo right ho jayega. But when you give Lakshmi, you feel doubtful, he karega ki nahi karega. Aur apni bhi aa sakti ho. I'm saying we also are attached, is it not? We are bahane hai, karega, nahi karega, wo to bahane hai. We are ourselves attached to not give money. See, there are many devotees who don't have money, I agree. But there are many who have also and they don't give. Or then you don't use themselves for Krishna Seva. Kabhi aap soche, just make some khichdi and feed some poor people. Prasadam only. What is the difficulty? Khud nahi kar sakte. And see how you... Poor means not only poor people, even people who are wealthy, they don't just get prasadam. I remember it's really funny. I had to give class in Rohini temple, ISKCON Rohini. I think it was 4 or 5 years back. So I was the cook also. We went there, I cooked khichdi and, you know, made pineapple halwa. And you'll be surprised, the person's father is sponsored. He's a crorepati. And that, 100 crores of, 100 actually, 100 crores. And that fellow came. I said, khichdi bahut achhi banayi, pack bhi karke le gaya. He also packed khichdi with it. It's amazing, a person who has crores of rupees. His wife also was devotee, cooked very nicely, but he appreciated khichdi so much, he brought khichdi also with his home. People packed the pineapple halwa, you know, because when you cook for Krishna, I mean, conscious, that taste is different. Samajh rahe baat. So everybody should think how I can help people to connect to Krishna. अरे हम थोड़ा अदर चले गए. पॉइंट इज दैट कर्मणैव हि सत्यम आस्थितः जनकादय. सो दैट बाय डूइंग, हाँ, सो व्हाट आई वांटेड टू से दैट बाय डूइंग देयर प्रिस्क्राइब्ड ड्यूटीज एंड अलोंग विद श्रवण कीर्तन दे गॉट प्यूरिफाइड एंड दे गॉट द रियलाइजेशन ऑफ द आत्मा. लोक संग्रहम एवापि संपश्यन् कर्तुम् अर्हसि. सो इन ऑर्डर टू टीच पीपल, वन, औ अर्जुन, वन, यू डिजर्व टू डू योर ड्यूटीज प्रॉपरली. even if you are a pure devotee, not even if you are a pure devotee, but you must act in a way so that other people who need to do those duties must do their duties nicely. ठीक है, ओके, ओके, नेक्स्ट. What is the, this is a very beautiful shloka. Yesterday one devotee was asking how to, he had a newborn daughter, how to make her a devotee. Just you be a devotee and she will be a devotee. What else she can be? If you are worshipping Krishna, she will not worship Durga, natural, or Lord Shiva. Option hi nahi hai koi. यद यदाचरति श्रेष्ठस्तत्तदेवतरो जनः स यत् प्रमाणं कुरुते लोकस्तद् अनुवर्तते. इट्स अ ब्यूटिफुल श्लोक. दिस श्लोक शुड बी आवर गाइडिंग प्रिंसिपल. यद यद आचरति श्रेष्ठस, वॉट एवर आचरण, वॉट एवर एग्जाम्पल अ सुपीरियर इज सेटिंग, तत्तद एव इतरः जनः. इतरः मीन्स हु आर सेपरेट फ्रॉम सुपीरियर. दोज हु आर नॉट सुपीरियर, दे विल फॉलो. मेक सेंस? स यत् प्रमाणम कुरते, वॉट एवर ही सेट्स, दिस इज एविडेंस, दिस इज करेक्ट. लोकस्तद अनुवर्तते, द कॉमन पीपल विल फॉलो. वी हैव गिवन लॉट ऑफ एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑन दिस. जस्ट लाइक नाउ डेज आर यू नोटिसिंग देर आर डिफरेंट डिफरेंट फैशन अमंग माता जी स्पेसिफिकली. आई एम नॉट अगेंस्ट दैट, आई एम अगेंस्ट दैट, बट आई एम जस्ट सेइंग दैट. सो फ्रॉम वेयर दिस ऑल इज कमिंग, यू नो फ्रॉम वेयर इट, बॉलीवुड इज इट नॉट? Something strange, is it not? Shrestha people are doing their things. They are superior people. This is very good. It happens, right? And you see how when people associate with devotees, especially boys, they look very nice. Baal chila ke achhe lag rahe. Many times people do that also.
I met one devotee yesterday. Today you have to.
हाँ, सो दे विल स्टार्ट वेयरिंग धोती कुर्ता. इवन यू सी पीपल वॉन्ट टू लुक फैशनेबल, दे विल हैव नाइस फैशनेबल धोती कुर्तास. आई एम जस्ट सेइंग, वी ऑलवेज गेट इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय पीपल हु आर सुपीरियर. कुछ ग्रहण करें. नाउ व्हाई आई विल होम होल्डिंग ऑन टू दिस श्लोक इज, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू प्रीच, जस्ट सेट अ वेरी गुड एग्जाम्पल. इफ आई डोंट सेट अ गुड एग्जाम्पल, नो बडी विल लिसन. I mean, they will listen, but they will not listen. सुनने वाले नहीं आपकी बात, वो देख रहे हैं कि क्या कर रहे हैं प्रभु जी. इसके लिए तुम प्रीचिंग नहीं करना चाहते. That's why we don't want to preach, because we'll have to set an example. And someday or another, people will find what we are doing. But it's actually very easy, is it not? Everybody is seeing how devotees are chanting Hare Krishna. Then new people also began to chant Hare Krishna. Everybody sees on Zoom, especially on Zoom, that they are chanting Hare Krishna from early morning hours. New person also wants to do that. Does it make sense? It is very powerful shloka. Even if you want to just convert one person, set up a good example. As much good we can be, we are not perfect, but as much good we can be. This is a very nice shloka. So many times people say that the kids don't listen. But I am seeing some devotees who don't follow my example on Zoom. I am waking up at Manga for Mangala Arati, but some of my students are not waking up for Mangala Arati. Oh, maybe they have found fault with this shloka, is it not? प्रभु जी आपको एक जन्म, जब पूरा मंगल आरती आएंगे तब हम एक दिन मंगल आरती आएंगे. होता है ना, when for 10,000 years when a devotee has practiced austerity, when Lord Vishnu becomes to manifest himself, similarly there are some devotees who will say, प्रभु जी when whole life they will perform austerity, then we will appear for मंगल आरती. Anyway, I'm just joking. There are many devotees are doing it nicely also. So now able to follow this, this is extremely important. See, that's why Srila Prabhupada's purports are so powerful. He practiced what he preached. आप देख सकते हैं इस बात को. प्रभुपाद जो जो कर, he has not told many things which people are doing right now. If you sometimes read his books, you will never find people do so many things. Already one devotee was doing some extra tapasya, and Prabhupada says, don't do more tapasya. It is already there is sufficient tapasya. Don't imagine your own. And I am personally seeing, I'm not chastising anybody, but I'm just saying generally, for people to do the same thing over and over again is most difficult. But this is the only way we can increase our mode of goodness. And after that increases, it is so relishable. You don't want to change the plan. I think of almost many of the devotees must be feeling who are doing regular sadhana, every day Mangalarti, every day chanting, every day. And it has to all go in like a same time. Do you agree? It is very relishable if you actually feel like that, if you have experience of that. So it may appear unpalatable, but if you keep doing it every day, then you will not be able to do it. It will be very bad. I will understand what I am trying to say. Okay. Then Lord Himself says that how He Himself is performing duties, although He does not have to do any duties. Why? Yadeda acharati srishtas. So then Lord says His own example. Name parthasti kartavyam trishu lokeshukan. Kishchana, kashchana, nana vaptama vaptavyam vata eva cha karmani name parthasti kartavyam. O partha, na asti, there is nothing which exists, no kartavyam, no duty exists for me. See, duties are there for a person who has an impure heart, who is bound by karma. Krishna is not bound by karma, he is Supreme Lord, so he does not have to do any duty. Trishu lokeshu kanch, what is it? Kashchana, is it not? Kinchana. Yeah. Trishu lokeshu kinchana. Kinchana means nothing. Not even this world, not even in the next world. Kuch bhi nahi prapt karna hai. Nana avaptam avaptavyam. This is nothing which is not achieved by me. Sab kuch to mera hi hai. And avaptavyam is that nothing is there for me to achieve. Something. If you want to achieve, you do something, do some austerity to achieve that. Kuch hai nahi Bhagwan ke liye. Everything belongs to Krishna already. Varta eva cha karmani, by which I, for which I must do some action. There is nothing to be achieved by me by doing some actions. So Lord is explaining His supreme position in this shloka. Are you able to understand? In this world, we have to do so many things. At 9:15, you cannot say, I am self-satisfied. Can you? Would you? We have to move from here to whatever, Prasadam Hall. You cannot say we are self-satisfied. But the Lord is fully satisfied. Atma Ramaha. Then also He does His duties. Why like this? His duties means when He comes as a Kshatriya, He will do those duties. Just like He worships Brahmana Sudama. When he also worships Naradji. And to the effect he says, oh Naradji, we are so fallen grihasthas. You are a Paramahansa Vaishnava. You have come to our home. All the drama Krishna does. And we are so fortunate you have come here. What service we can do to you? And more than that, he then also worships the feet of Naradji. He washes the feet of Naradji. And it's amazing, Naradji knows His Supreme Personality of Godhead. Is it too much? Is it not too much? It's really too much. The Supreme Personality of Godhead is washing your feet. So Naradji knows because he's teaching an example for other Kshatriyas that they should never go against the Brahmanas. So what if the Supreme Lord does not do? Yadi aham na varteyam jatu karmanya tandritaha mama vartmanu vartante manashya paartha sarvasha. Yadi, if He certainly, yadi aham na vartyam, if I am not following this path, I am not doing these duties, jatu karmani atandritaha. Tandra, you understand? Tandra, I think we understand very nicely. Sleep. Inattentiveness. So atandraha means with full attention. So if I don't, jatu at any point of time, jatu means at any point of time, if I don't do the duties properly. Mama vartma anuvartante. Vartma means path. And anuvartante means follow. So people will follow my path. Manushyaha path sarvashaha. All the human beings will follow my path. O partha. Follow kar pa rahe hain? Kyo bhagwan karte hain karma? What will happen by that? if people follow your path and if you don't do your duties and people follow your path, then what will happen? That is in text number 24. Utse deyuri me loka na kuryam karma chedaham sankarasya cha kartasyam upahanyami mahapraja. Utse deyur, what is purpose is, would be put into your room. Ime loka. Ime means all this, in this world. Loka means the common people. All the common people will be put into ruination. Barbaad ho jayenge. Na kuryam karma chedaham yadi. Ched means if I don't perform my duties. Are you able to relate? They will say Krishna is not doing. Why should I do? Theek hai? And what will happen? Sankarasya cha kartasyam. I will be the cause of creating unwanted population. Sankara means which are mixed, who are not trained properly. Upahanyami mahapraja. Upahanyam, I think it means. Yes. And they will destroy other living entities, which is happening now here. You see, all these scientists, most of the scientists who are doing all this GMO and all this nonsense research, it is not benefiting the humanity. Rather, they are purposefully doing it to destroy humanity. So why is it like that? Now you understand? Because varnashram principles are not followed, unwanted population is there, and then they do nonsense and they will kill people. All these terrorists who think that they will go to heaven by killing people. Quite is amazing, is it not? One sannyasi was joking. They will be really surprised when they reach that heaven. It doesn't look like the way it was told to them. They will be going to hellish destination, but they are so convinced. Now, have you a little drift from this point? Have you ever thought how they can think like this? What's the reason to think like this, that by killing people I'll go to heaven? Can anybody think? Mind gets trained. That's what I'm saying. How the mind got trained? Because of Mahat Seva Dwara Mahur Vimukte. They have served the great saintly people. It is sarcastically. They've heard again and again, hearing. That's why they are convinced of something different goal, opposite goal. By killing people, innocent people, they will go to heaven. Because of their sadhu sangha. So if we don't hear, I would say like this. If we don't hear, we will not be here. Samajh rahe hain baat? That determination to do tapasya will only happen when we hear properly. That's why morning and evening we should hear. So anyhow, upahanyami mahapraja means that they are going to destroy the population. It is interesting that one comment is there by a devotee that it is not, problem is not overpopulation, the problem is what the population is doing. Ye baat yahan pe siddh ho rahi hai. Have you not reflected in our temple so many devotees can take prasadam? And in home, many times there is fight over food. Have you ever seen? For few people? Think about it. If people are not disciplined, they are not grateful for what they are receiving. What a strange situation is created. Once you start living in devotee communities, very difficult to tolerate a home because people fight over stupid matters. Do you agree? There's no basis. Have you ever fought over a dhoti? No. ये तो कभी बहुत सारे कारण होते हैं झगड़ा करने के लिए भक्तों से अच्छा भी लगता है. But we may fight. Really, Gaurangpur was making fun. Sometimes devotees argue and little bit altercation is there. He said, you must remember, if Prabhupada would have not preached, we would have been fighting over a pan store. We might have been standing over a pan store and fighting over some pan or some political thing. At least we are fighting over some, maybe some philosophical points or something like that. Anyway, so we just discussed that overpopulation is not a problem. The problem is Varna Sankar population. Okay. Saktaha kana. So how one should act? सक्तः कर्माण्य विद्वांसो यथा कुर्वन्ति भारता कुर्याद विद्वांस तथा सक्तश्चिकीर्षु लोक संग्रहम. सक्तः कर्माणि अविद्वांसः यथा कुर्वन्ति भारता. ओ भारता, ओ अर्जुन, The way our attached person is doing his action, sakta means attached and karmani means actions. Avidvansa, who does not know, that the goal of life is self-realization, yatha kurvanti. The way attached people who are not knowledgeable of scriptures act, kuryad vidvans tatha asakta. Similar way a person should act enthusiastically, but asakta. In a detached manner. Arjuna was fighting with a detached spirit and Duryodhana was fighting with attached spirit. Antar dekh rahe hain dono mein. But the enthusiasm to fight was same. Prabhupada gave the example. I remember correctly, in the purport he says, a devotee may appear to be acting as if he's karmi or something like that. Like Prabhupada was worried how to get money for building ISKCON Vrindavan, or he was fighting a court case for ISKCON Juhu. You should be detached. But then Prabhupada said, no, I had promised to Radha Ras Bihari, I'll make a temple for you here. Similarly, Shripad Madhavendpuri was asked by Gopal, you please bring sandalwood for me. So he goes all the way to Jagannath Puri to get sandalwood. That person who was so detached, he had no duty to perform, he's so much enthusiastic to bring sandalwood for Gopal. Kuch grahan kar rahe hain? But not even a pinch for himself. I think you are able to understand. Chikirshu Loka Sangraham, by which an example is set in front of others how to act for Krishna enthusiastically, in a detached manner. Theek hai? Not attached for mundane material achievements. Okay. And those people, and somebody says, no, but we can directly tell them your soul, not the body, give up your home. What is the point of doing all these duties? What is the point of bringing kids up? What is it? Then say, no. Na buddhi bhedam janayet agyanam karma sanginam joshayet sarva karmani vidvan yukta samacharam. Na buddhi bhedam, unki buddhi ko puncture nahi kijiye. Don't puncture their intelligence. Their intelligence, you say, no, these duties are very important and you must not puncture their intelligence. That means those who can't accept the knowledge of bhakti yoga, they must do their duties. That's why Lord says, na buddhi bhedam janet agyanam karma sanginam. Karma sanginam, those who are very attached to those actions. Sangi means attached. So don't tell them, hey, bhai, what is the point of marrying? What is the point of your atma? Kisse atma? Atma ki atma shadi kaise hogi? You can't preach to them, what is the point of getting married? Or all those things. People who are attached to all those actions, they have to do those actions, but they have to be taught to do those actions in a detached manner. Ye baat bol rahe. Joshayet sarva karmani vidvan yuktah samacharam. Joshayet means you engage them in all kind of actions prescribed by Vedas. Vidvan yuktah samacharam. A person who is knowledgeable will engage them in actions, but then but in a way they will teach them how to become detached from enjoying spirit slowly. Theek hai. Next. Now it's something very interesting. Even if a person is knowledgeable of scriptures, still he will behave as per the impressions which he has received from the previous lives. So it's not very easy for people to change their swabhav. So the instruction is to engage the swabhav in Krishna Seva. Prakriti hai kriya manani gunai karmani sarvashah ahankar vimudatma karta ham iti manyate. Prakriti hai kriya manani, from the material modes of nature, these gunas, actions are kriyaman, they are in action. They are impelling people to act in a certain way. Gunai karmani sarvashah, all the actions are done by the modes of material nature. Acha, I am not at all doer. No, we desire things, but then the actions are done by the modes of material nature. Ahankar vimudatma karta aham iti manyate. A person who is bewildered by false ego thinks that I am doing all those things. So bhul gaye, And that's why people become proud. I have done this, I have did this, I did this, I did this, like this, like this, like this.
तत्ववित्तु महाबाहो गुणकर्मा विभागयो गुणागुणेषु वर्तन्त इति मत्वा न सज्जति. बट अ पर्सन हुज तत्ववित, तत्व मीन्स हु नोज द ट्रुथ. हो महाबाहो हुज यू आर वेरी पावरफुल, योर आर्म्स आर वेरी पावरफुल. गुण कर्म विभागयो, ही अंडरस्टैंड्स. विभाग मीन्स डिफरेंट डिपार्टमेंट्स. ही अंडरस्टैंड्स एक्शंस, डिफाइन्स द मोड्स ऑफ मटेरियल नेचर. गुणागुणेशु वर्तन्ते, ही नोज दैट द सेंसेस आर एंगेज इन देयर सेंस ऑब्जेक्ट्स. इति मत्वा न सज्जते, ही डज नॉट बिकम अटैच्ड टू देम. प्रभु जी कुछ तो एक्सप्लेन करो. कर चुका हूँ, अभी तो मैं ओवरव्यू दे रहा हूँ. मुझे पता है सब बात है. देखिए भगवत गीता बहुत कठिन है एक्चुअली. टू अंडरस्टैंड भगवत गीता इज डिफिकल्ट, सो यू हैव टू हियर ईच एंड एवरी श्लोका प्रॉपरली, देन यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड.
प्रकृतिर्गुण समूढ़ा सज्जन्ते गुणकर्मसु तान कृतस्न विदो मंदान कृतस्न विन्न विचालयेत. प्रकृतिर्गुण समूढ़ा, दोज हु आर कंप्लीटली बिविल्डर्ड बाय द मोड्स ऑफ मटेरियल नेचर. सज्जन्ते गुणकर्मसु, दे बिकम अटैच्ड टू द एक्शंस व्हिच आर बॉर्न फ्रॉम मोड्स ऑफ मटेरियल नेचर. अटैच्ड टू सेंस ग्रेटिफिकेशन, ये करना बहुत जरूरी है, बहुत मेहनत करेंगे.
पीपल कैन, आई हैव सीन वन ऑफ माय रिलेटिव्स स्टूड फॉर 40 आवर्स to replace, to get a boiler plant replaced, whatever, repaired. And if you ask him to sit down, maybe he's now chanting 16 rounds. So much of the energy gets used in all those things. Anyways,
tan akritasna vid mandan. Akritasna vid means, kritasna means completely, and akritasna means not completely. Vid means not knower. A person does not know completely. Mandan was foolish. To that person, kritasna vin na vichaliyat. A person who knows properly, he should not disturb them. Is for their adhikar, it is needed that they must act in that way. One of our students got married. He was married, and he was married to a devotee only. But now he is realizing. Now he's self-realized. But he had to realize it himself. He could not get the realization by others. Now he's saying, think of vanaprastha life, but it's too early. You have to suffer more. you have to get more realization. It's not that easy. Self-realization means self-realization, is it not? You have to realize yourself. Now, which path you want to achieve by for self-realization is on your choice. Anyways, sometimes when I see my sister's kid give too much trouble, I ask my mother, was I also giving so much trouble? She said, no, at least to me. She will give me some milk and I will just sleep. I'll take that milk and say, okay, so achhe gun to bachpan se hi the. Not giving trouble too much to people. You know?
Why can't we to chill kyun nahi rehte logon ko samajh nahi aata. Why can't we people cool down, you know? Some people are so much worried about what others are doing. Why cool, chill, is it not? Chill raho. Anyhow, chalo different karke baat. But really it is a misery. I mean, I don't know what people say, but kids are a big trouble, you know. You can't eat also properly. And there is no control. It's not an alarm which you say, chup. आधे घंटे बाद आफ्टर हाफ एन आवर इज इट बिकम मोर स्ट्रांग. व्हाट अ मिजरी. वन ब्राह्मण वाज सेइंग दैट शास्त्र डज नॉट स्पीक व्हाट यू शुड डू व्हेन द किड विल क्राई इन द नाइट. शास्त्र डज नॉट से एनीथिंग. अरे बाबा, दिस इज एग्जॉल्टेड आश्रम. Let us come back to our shloka.
Mai sarvani karmani sanyasa dhyatma chetasa nirashi nirmamo bhutva yuddhasva vigata chora.
So they should not disturb those people who are attached to work. And you, oh Arjuna, you should act in this way, the Lord is saying. Mai sarvani karmani, offering all your actions to me, sanyasa adhyatma chetasa. Adhyatma chetasa means understanding I am part and parcel of Krishna. So I must act for him. Nirashi,
निराशी मीन्स विदाउट एनी होप्स फॉर मटीरियल रेम्यूनरेशन, इससे मुझे क्या मिलेगा मटीरियली। निर्मम, दिस थिंग बिलोंग्स टू मी, नो नो नो, एवरीथिंग बिलोंग्स टू कृष्णा। भूत्वा being having become like this, yuddhasva vigata jwara, you fight with lot of enthusiasm. Jwara means fever, we don't like to do anything in the fever. So that's a vigata jwara means without this feverish mentality, mera to kuch hai nahi, I'm not going to get anything from this, still enthusiastically you do your services, realizing that this Krishna will be pleased by this. If I act properly, it would be a good standard for others, and then they will also get uplifted by following the example. कुछ समझ में भी आ रहा है, मैं बोलते ही जा रहा हूं। प्रभु जी श्लोक तो समझ में आ रहे हैं, I can understand the shloka, but your explanation are like clouds which are completely covering the meaning of the shlokas. One time Bhurijan Prabhu was giving class, so after he finished the class, one devotee, I think one another sannyasi was there, I don't know who was that devotee, and then he said, Bhurijan Prabhu said, you please say something, some remark. So Prabhuji, he said, no, Prabhuji, you covered everything. Then Prabhuji changed the meaning. He said, yes, I covered everything. The meaning was clear, but my explanation covered everything. they joke also like this. What is the benefit if I follow your instruction? ये मे मतमिदं नित्यं अनुतिष्ठन्ति मानवः श्रद्धावन्तो अनसूयन्तो मुच्यन्ते तेऽपि कर्मभि। ये मे मतम इदं नित्यं, दोज हु फॉलो माय मत, दोज हु फॉलो माय इंस्ट्रक्शन, अनुतिष्ठन्ति मानवः, ऑलवेज सिचुएटेड इन माय इंस्ट्रक्शन, आई विल फॉलो दिस बिकॉज इट्स लॉर्ड्स इंस्ट्रक्शन, दैट ह्यूमन बीइंग, मानवः मीन्स एनीवन, श्रद्धावन्तो अनसूयन्तो, दोज हु आर हैविंग फेथ इन कृष्णस इंस्ट्रक्शन, हां सही है, अनुसूयंतो, those who are not envious of Krishna, he's a human being, कौन होता है बोलने वाला? Have you heard this statement about yourself many times? Who do you think you are to tell me this? This is called enviousness. Even if you are telling the correct thing, people will not listen. So Krishna says अनुसूयंतो, they are not envious of Krishna. Oh, my supreme Lord has told, we will do that. मुच्यन्ते पि कर्मभि, they also become liberated from bondage. ठीक है, इवन वाइल एक्टिंग, ये ते तद अभ्यसूयंतो न अनुतिष्ठन्ति मे मतम सर्वज्ञान विमूढ़ास्तान विधि नष्टान चेतस। सो आई हैव सेवरल टाइम्स एक्सप्लेन्ड, द लॉर्ड विल गिव अ पॉजिटिव इंस्ट्रक्शन एंड द बेनिफिट, एंड देन ही विल गिव अ नेगेटिव इंस्ट्रक्शन एंड द how to say the implication of it. So this is a negative instruction. If you don't do, what will happen? Ye tu, tu means but those etad abhyasuyanto, those who are envious of these instructions, na anutishtanti, those who do not situate themselves in me matam, in my instructions. Samajh rahe hain? If Krishna says you offer your food to me, so you say, oh yes, yes, my Supreme Lord, I'll offer. So you are situated in the instruction of the Supreme Lord. Samajh rahe? So then, if I'm not doing it, I'm not situated in the matam of Krishna. Makes sense? Very easy. Sarva jnan vimudhastan, they are, all their knowledge is lost. Sarva jnan vimudha, they are foolish. They will not understand anything. Why? Viddhi nashtana chetasa. You must understand, Viddhi, you must understand, they are, their chetana is destroyed. Means they are completely forgetful that they are soul, not the body. Samajh rahe na? Okay. We always remember, when we serve Krishna, Krishna's reciprocation is that he reveals spiritual knowledge within our heart. You always remember this. Whenever you act for Krishna, Krishna gives you the highest, priceless gift is he gives you transcendental knowledge. If you can remember that we are Krishna's servants, that is the highest, achievement for us. Samajh rahe hain baat ko? Bahut achhi baat hai. But if we don't engage in Krishna seva, this will happen. Our consciousness is lost. We simply think we are these bodies, we are in jars of this material world, and act thereof. My English is, I think, not that difficult to understand, na? Sadrisham cheshtate swasyaha prakritir jnanavanapi prakritim yanti bhutani nigraha kim karishati. सदृष्टम चेष्टते स्वस्या प्रकृतेर। सदृशम मीन्स लाइक एंड स्वस्या प्रकृति मीन्स द स्वभाव और द नेचर द कंडीशन नेचर विच इज बॉर्न फ्रॉम द मोड्स ऑफ मटेरियल नेचर। चेष्टते पर्सन एक्ट्स एज अ पर्सन हैज डेवलप्ड हिज कंडीशन नेचर दैट वे ही एक्ट्स ऑलवेज सिमिलर टू दैट ही एक्ट्स। नहीं समझ रहे हैं? He must be foolish, that's why he acts. No. Gyanvan api. Grahan kar pa rahe hain? Even if a person is knowledgeable of scriptures, but he acts as similar to his nature, which is acquired from the modes of material nature, from his previous lives. Ye bahut badi kathinai hai bahut. प्रकृतिम यान्ति भूतानि निग्रह किम करिष्यति। देयर इज अ पॉइंट, व्हाट इज अ पॉइंट ऑफ रिप्रेशन, दे विल बिहेव द वे दे विल बिहेव ओनली। प्रकृतिम यान्ति भूतानि, यान्ति मीन दे गो टू देयर कंडीशन नेचर एंड दे बिहेव लाइक दिस ऑल द लिविंग एंटिटीज। समबडी इज मेनी डिवोटीज विल से लाइक दैट ऑल्सो दैट वी आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम एंगर, वी डोंट वॉन्ट टू बी एंग्री, वी टेंड टू बिकम एंग्री, वी नो दैट एंगर इज नॉट गुड but we tend to become angry. Some people say we fall prey to lust. All those things are there. Samajh rahe baat ko? Yes. This is very dangerous. So even if a person is knowledge of the scriptures, then you say, kya fayda? Then there's no point. If I will have to act the way I have to act, then what's the point of scriptures? No, that is not the solution. That is not the proper argument. Let us first understand what the Lord says. Indriyasya indriyasyathe raga desho vivasthitau tayornavasham agachetau hiyasya paripanthinau. Indriyasya indriyasyathe, the senses and the sense objects, form, taste, and other thing. Raga desho vivasthitau, the senses are very nicely situated, vivasthitau, in attachment and aversion to their sense object. I may like a form, the other person will not like that form. I may like a taste, other person will not like the taste. Samajh rahe hain baat ko? Tayor na vasham agachet, one should not come under the control of that attachment and aversion. I hope you are able to remember. Because people who don't follow Shastra, they will be under the control of that aversion and attachment. One should not talk to other's wife, but that he will forget. You remember all those things we have discussed? And they'll say, what benefit I'm going, what, it's so nice, why should I not talk? And the instruction is that, this is because of rag. And the instruction of Shastra says, you associate with saintly people. Hey, what I'm going to get by associating with sadhus? That is dvesh. So in that way his knowledge was covered, and that's why he says tau hi asya paripanthano. Tau means these two, attachment and aversion to mundane things, are robbers on the path of self-realization. Kuch grahan kar pa rahe hain? The injunction which is against his self-realization because of rag, he won't listen. An injunction which is for his self-realization because of dvesh, he won't listen. श्रेयान सुधर्म विगुणः परधर्मास्वनिष्ठता सुधर्म निधनम श्रेयो परधर्मो भयावह। सो अर्जुन कैन से दैट सो बेटर टू सो यू सी आई कैन नॉट डू माय ड्यूटीज ऑफ क्षत्रिय विदाउट राग एंड द्वेष। जस्ट नाउ बोला ना आपने अभी, दिस राग एंड द्वेष इज वेरी बैड, बट आई कैन नॉट, इफ आई हैव टू फाइट आई हैव टू हैव द्वेष एंड आई मस्ट हैव सम व्हाट इज दैट गोल of attaining some mundane achievement, that is rag. So better I perform like a brahmana. You remember those links? Very interesting links. He said, no, the Lord says, no, shreyan sudharma vigunha, even if you are doing your swadharma with faults, it is better than paradharma swanushtita, trying to do others' duties very nicely. Why? Because even if you are not able to do your duties properly now, but there will not be any sin, and you will get further qualified in the future lifetimes. All those things I am speaking from the commentaries which we have discussed. So nothing new I am speaking, only brushing up the things there. Swadharme nidhanam shreya. Nidhanam is die. It is better to die doing one's own duty. Varadharma bhayavahat. But it's very, very, very fearful to do somebody else's duties. Nahi hota hai kisi ka. Okay. Arjuna vacha. अर्जुन उवाच अथ केना प्रयुक्तोयं पापं चरति पुरुषः अनिच्छन्नपि वार्ष्णेया बलादिव नियोजितः. बिफोर वी टेक अप दिस आई फॉरगॉट वन पॉइंट. अ पर्सन हु इज नॉलेजेबल ऑफ स्क्रिप्चर्स ही मे स्टिल परफॉर्म बैड थिंग्स बट द सॉल्यूशन वी हैव हर्ड वाज एसोसिएशन ऑफ डिवोटीज. And by that association of devotees, by hearing and chanting in the association of devotees, one very easily gives up bad things, which we are seeing in our own life. There's something very strange because Krishna becomes pleased and Krishna removes the enjoying propensities within our heart. I just forgot that point. So I'm just mentioning here. Now Arjuna asks, Atha kena prayuktoyam papam charati purusha. O Krishna, who engages a person in sinful activities? So, anichan api varshneya, O best among the Vrishnis, people are performing sins even against their will. Why is like that? Baladiva niyojita, as if they are engaged by force. That was is a question. Is it the Supreme Lord? No. Is it the free will only? No. श्री भगवान वाचा कामेश क्रोधेश रजोगुण समुद्भव महाशनो महापापमा विधेयनम हि वैरिणाम. सुप्रीम लॉर्ड सेड कामेश क्रोधेश. दिस इज लस्ट. दिस लस्ट एंड दिस एंगर रजोगुण समुद्भव विच इज बॉर्न फ्रॉम मोड ऑफ पैशन. महाशना इज ऑल डिवोरिंग. अशना मीन्स टू ईट. इट कंप्लीटली ईट्स अप आवर कॉन्शियसनेस. वी फॉरगेट दैट वी आर सोल. You forget that we are by enjoying senses, I'm not going to become happy. Mahapapma, it is sinful. Vidhyanam iha varinam. This is the shatru of the living entity, you must remember. And do you remember, my dear devotees, what is lust? What equation I explained to you? Impressions plus free will is equals to lust. Impressions in itself are dead. They can't force us. But when we supply them their free will, then they become karma. See, in your own life, you must be seeing, I mean, we have done sense gratification, but so many thoughts come. We just neglect it. We don't act on it, is it not? We keep on chanting, we do our services like that. But as soon as we start meditating upon it, then we are supplying them so much, energy of our free will, that we think, are isko kiye bina to hum kuch sukhi nahi ho sakte. Without doing such an act, I will not become happy. This is practically observed by all devotees. So we have to stop at the free will level only. By being in the association of devotees, by practicing sadhana, and to the degree we develop mode of goodness, to that degree we become lesser and lesser prone to such fall downs. Samajh rahe baat ko? Because the word here is rajoguna samudbhava. To the degree we associate with rajoguna, again and again, mode of passion, a mode of, that means the products of, that products means lust and anger will manifest again and again. Okay, just hold on with me. There are few slokas only. How does this lust cover the knowledge of the living entities? Dhumena vriyate vahanir yatha darsho malena chayatholvena avrito garbhastathate netam avritam. Dhumena avriyate vahanir. Just like fire is covered by smoke. It means little bit. And there is movement in the fire and there is heat. You remember those things? And yatha darsho malena cha. So the fire can still perform its action, although it is covered by smoke. Example is given by human form of life, which has some spiritual cultivation. Kab bataya tha aapne? डेट देख लेना जिस दिन पोस्टिंग किया था सब बता चुका हूं. यथा आदर्श मलिन चा. आदर्श मीन्स मिरर. बट if it gets covered by dust, it cannot perform its action. Theek hai? And it is fixed. That was compared to animal life. Remember, Prabhupada told, and yatha ulbena avrito garbhas, just like the child within the womb of the mother is completely covered. You can't see it. There is no movement. इट इज कंपेयर टू द लाइफ ऑफ ट्रीज. समझ रहे हैं इस बात को. इन सिमिलर वे द लस्ट इज कवरिंग द रियल नॉलेज ऑफ द लिविंग एंटिटी. आवृतम ज्ञानमेतेना ज्ञानिनो नित्यवैरिणा कामरूपेण कौन्तेया दुष्पुरेण नलेन च. आवृतम ज्ञानमेतेना, दिस लस्ट इज कवरिंग द नॉलेज ऑफ द लिविंग एंटिटीज. ज्ञानिनो नित्यवैरिणा, इट इज द इटर्नल कॉन्स्टेंट एनिमी ऑफ द लिविंग एंटिटी. कामरूपेण कौन्तेया, इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लस्ट ओ कौन्तेया. दुष्पुरेण अनलेन च, Dushpurena means it is never satisfied, it is like fire. The more we satisfy the fire in terms of pouring ghee, it more becomes inflamed. Many devotees ask me, Grihasthas, Prabhuji, I am so much affected by lust. You were thinking that by getting married, you will manage your lust, lust will become less. Kabhi-kabhi log aisa preaching karte bhi hain. If you are too much lusty, you marry. I mean, just you don't do wrong things, it is told. It's not that bad marriage, a person becomes free from lust. Ab koi bol to nahi lene wala yahan pe, lekin it doesn't work like that. We become free from all those things by hearing about Krishna, by bhakti. Have I not been married previously? One time one Mataji said, I had a boyfriend, but he left me. मैंने कहा माताजी, नॉट वन बॉयफ्रेंड, यू हैड टू मेनी बॉयफ्रेंड्स, मेनी बॉयफ्रेंड्स. शी वाज सो मच अशेम्ड. नो नो प्रभुजी, आई ओनली हैड वन बॉयफ्रेंड, नॉट मेनी. मैंने कहा माताजी, मेनी लाइफ टाइम्स यू हैड मेनी बॉयफ्रेंड. ओह अच्छा 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 ना. आई सेड आई आल्सो हैड सो मेनी गर्लफ्रेंड्स, व्हाट डू यू थिंक? हैं गर्लफ्रेंड ब्रह्मचारी, होल्ड हिम डाउन, पुल हिम डाउन. नो नो, नॉट इन दिस लाइफ. आई वाज फॉर्चुनेट इन प्रीवियस लाइफ्स. सो मेनी गर्लफ्रेंड्स, इज नॉट इन लिजर्ड गर्लफ्रेंड, पिक गर्लफ्रेंड, काउ गर्लफ्रेंड, कोई हिसाब थोड़ी ना है. इज इट नॉट ओनली आफ्टर गेटिंग फ्रस्ट्रेटेड विद ऑल द गर्लफ्रेंड्स, दिस लाइफ आई एम ट्राइंग टू बी अ ब्रह्मचारी. आई वोंट से आई एम अ ब्रह्मचारी, ट्राइंग टू बी. गुड आइडिया इज इट नॉट. बहुत परेशान किया उन्होंने. ओके लास्ट फ्यू श्लोकस. Then the Lord is saying, this enemy is where this enemy is situated, so that we can identify. Indriyani mano buddhir asya tishthanam uchyate eter vimohayatesha jnanam avritya dehinam. Indriyani mano buddhir, indriyani means senses, mind and intelligence. Asya adishthanam uchyate are the sitting places of this lust. Eter vimohayatesha, sitting there, this lust is bewildering the living entities, thinking, oh, I'll enjoy that sense object, I'll be happy. Dekh lunga, chhu lunga, kha lunga. That's how we are bewildered. I'll touch this, I'll eat this, and all those things. In this way, the senses are bewildering us, and the mind is bewildered, and the intelligence is planning about sense objects. As soon as the intelligence is bewildered in terms of thinking, by enjoying that sense object, I'll become happy, immediately mind gives a signal to the senses. This is how the intelligence is bewildered. We have discussed this in that great length in the lectures there. Jnanam avritte dehinam. It covers the knowledge of the dehi, the living entity which is possessor of this body. Tasmat, therefore, tasmat vam indriyanyadau niyamya bharatarshabha papanam prajaheyenam jnana vijnana nashanam. Therefore, tvam, you, indriyanyadau, first control your senses. Because from there it gets the input. Niyamya Bharata Rishabha, you must regulate your senses. O Bharata Rishabha, O best among the Bharat Vanshis, or that means descendants of Bharat. Papmanam prajahi enam. Jahi means kill. This papman, this lusty lust which is full of sin, you must kill, which is Jnana Vijnana Nashanam, which is destroyer of knowledge and realization. Can I not make some reconciliation with lust? No. But before that, I cannot control my senses, I am so weak. No, you are superior to the senses, you are superior to mind. Listen to this. Indriyani paranyahur indriyebhya paramam manaha manasastu parabuddhir yo buddhe paratastu saha. Senses are superior to body. We have talked about subtle senses also. So the subtle senses are superior to the body and indriyebhya paramam mana. Thus, the mind is superior to the senses because it is the controller of the senses, and the intelligence is superior to mind because intelligence has the capacity to discern things. Is it good for you or not? And they say, no, don't do this. Are you not doing it with your mind many times? With intelligence. And yo buddhihe paratastusa, and that atma is superior to the intelligence also. The conscious living entity. So you cannot say that I cannot control my senses. And evam, last one. Evam buddhe param buddhva sansthabhyatmanam atmana jai shatrum mahabaho kamarupa durasadam. Evam buddhe param buddhva. By this transcendental intelligence, try to understand that you are superior to this body, to this intelligence also. Sansthabhyatmanam atmana. One should control. Sansthabhyatmanam, how does Prabhupada translate that? Deliberation. Steading, sansthabhya. Steading, atmanam, atmana. Steading the mind with the transcendental intelligence. Jahi shatru mahabahu. Kill this. Jahi means kill this. Kill this shatru. Kill this enemy. Oh mahabahu. You have killed so many enemies by your powerful arms. You are having very powerful arms. Now you should kill this lust. Kama rupam durasadam. This Shatru, this enemy which is very difficult to conquer. So from there on, the Lord will take to chapter number 4. The instruction of Bhagavad Gita in chapter number 3 is about offering actions to Krishna. And in that way, controlling our lusty thing, lusty desires get purified. Are there any? I will not do Parayan because we have done Parayan along with. I'll just take some questions. I know thoda sa late ho gaya hai, lekin I'll just take up some questions. भूख लग रही है तो मंगवाऊं प्रसाद यहीं पे. ओके, कहां थे? कोई प्रश्न नहीं है. आज कौन सा चैप्टर होगा? कल से 4 चैप्टर होगा. इज करेक्ट मीनिंग ऑफ यज्ञ इज एनी एक्टिविटी डन फॉर द प्लेजर ऑफ द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड? व्हाट्स आंसर? यस. One of my friend asked me to show him effect of Harinam and staying in Vrindavan. But as we know that all this happens at subtle level. What do you mean by show? Can you show me, Ayush Prabhu, that you are satisfied by eating food? Show? Show means what? You see, you. Can you show me how Rasgulla is tasty? You have to eat it. The taste of pudding lies in eating. Is it not? Abhi karne wale hain, ghabraiye mat. People are, what do you mean by show? Tell me, show ka matlab kya hai? What do you mean by show? Koi show chal raha hai, picture dikha rahe hai. What do you mean? You chant Hare Krishna, you feel peaceful. In this shloka, you said, greatest liberation is to always depend on Krishna. Twayeka. I don't know which shloka I said, I did not say. So how can we show him our liberation from our sinful activity? Are paap nahi kar rahe ho, to ye mukti nahi dikh rahi hai paap se. You are not doing sinful activity. Is it not showing your liberation from sinful activity? This is obvious, is it not? We are not. Are you chai bhi nahi peete? You don't even drink tea? You don't watch movies? Dikhane ki kya zarurat hai? Is it natural, is it not? If someone engages in activities related to Krishna, but not exclusively for the pleasure of Krishna, is such activities are yajna? Yes, they are also yajna, but you should start with that somewhere. Somewhere you should start. I am missing your pineapple halwa. I am missing you, my dear Prabhu. You please come and we'll feed you. Why do you worry? Recipe of Bhagwan. This is to do with bhakti yoga. Yeah, okay. Offering our karma. Okay. We'll make a channel. Ek bar khao. They are becoming nalayak. Please come, Vrindavan Akash. No. Now we'll not invite him. Even if you come, we'll block all the doors. Again, it's in the photos. Started doing. No, they are all making jokes now. Okay. New tagline: just chill. Yeah, this is a good thing. Just chill. Actually, chill. Don't. ये बहुत important बात है. People behave as they are supposed to behave. As per the how. कहाँ तक आप बताएंगे सबको? अब person कुछ बात सुन ले कलयुग में आपकी तो बहुत बड़ी बात है. So, समझ में पूरा आ रहा है. अरे वाह, good. because of aversion and attachment was impelled to act in a conditioned way. However, one must use his free will to act as per the scriptures, and that can only happen in the association of devotees. That is the point. Sometimes it is very difficult to control our senses, then what to do at that time? After looking some tasty food, well, offer the food to Krishna. But it should be limited to food only. Beyond that, it is dangerous. Satiety reflects on face after eating prasadam. Yeah, okay. Satiation. Okay. Can we really control population in the world as a human? No need to. Just make sure, obviously you can't do that, that the population is becoming a devotee of Krishna. You should remember this. There's a point is here. I have heard this, that people in America, government in America is throwing grains in the waters so that the price of grains don't come down. And just imagine how much charity they can give. And people in Africa are dying out of hunger. This we have heard in Netherlands, somewhere in Australia, they have so much milk they throw in the sea. So this Mother Earth can give 100 Griffin feet to so many people. But all this is because of the mismanagement of the government. Prabhupada says it so many times in his purports. So we don't have to control population growth. We have to see that good population is coming. So there are some devotees who would like to do that service, they can do that. Some devotees want to. But you see, that is kind of impractical. You can't control those things. So don't think about those things. Try to add your might. You whatever you can do. I know back doors. Okay. Take care. So, we shall stop here. You got some understanding. We'll meet in the evening today. We have no Mridanga class today. Because devotees are not learning.